We're joined by legendary Moss wrestler Lindsay Hall, who is one of the top in the world. She took silver at the World Nomad Games in Kyrgyzstan. She took silver at the World Championships in Yakutsk, Russia last year. And we're both headed to the World Championships in Poland again this year, so keep an eye out for what she can do. She's here to help me. She's also my training partner, which means I have to be in tip-top shape to be able to keep up. And we're going to go over some basics of setting up right now. The first three things on our magic list will be feet, hands, and hips. So let's talk about feet. They have to start heels down between these lines. That's going to be tough if you're particularly tight. If you get to the board and you can't quite get your feet in there because something, because your hamstrings, because your back, something's tight, that position might be tricky for you. So at least be able to get your feet between those lines. Where they go between those lines for now is entirely up to you. Where do you feel comfortable? Eventually there will be some strategy. I know what she's capable of, I know what she's gonna do to me, I know how she's gonna attack me, so I will have a certain foot position to counter her. And eventually as you get to know your opponents, you'll do the same. But for now, put your feet where you're comfortable. It's probably gonna be similar to your deadlift stance, your conventional deadlift stance. Although this actually is more of a sumo because your hands are in between. So let's talk about hands. This is the stick. They're gonna go either on the outside of the stick or the inside of the stick with a mixed grip. Now, if this were a official Moss wrestling board, we would have a red side and a blue side. And I have the reversible shorts to match, so whatever side I'm on, I can flip my shorts around and be prepared. And you'll have to do something like that. You'll have to have your red or blue shorts if you're doing official Moss wrestling. The hands, therefore, are dictated by what side you're on. If you're on the red side, that picks first. Blue side picks on the next round, and then it's a random draw for the third round, if it goes that far. It is a mixed grip. No, unfortunately, my weightlifting friends, you cannot hook grip. Mixed grip, and you better get comfortable. If you're doing Moss a lot, you better get comfortable with being able to over or underhand, inside or outside, either hand. So that's four positions you have to choose from. So for instance, we're gonna pretend she's red side. She gets to pick. Little inside secret about Lindsay, she loves inside grip. Which means I have to go outside grip. So if I grab to the outside, that's how we start our grip. Now I picked my foot position already, as did she, but we can change it around if we need to. We haven't started yet. Now the other thing about grip is eventually over time, there's a handful of techniques and strategies that you want. I want to look where her hands are, figure out certain strategies to maybe be able to break her grip during the match. And she's doing the same to me. That's why she prefers the inside. She might have some strategy to break my grip. Don't worry about that for now. Do not worry about that for now. We'll get into that later. Pick your inside or outside, depending on what side of the board you're on, and get comfortable eventually with all four of those positions. Before I talk about hips, quick thing about the stick. The match doesn't start until the referee sees that the stick is right over the board, right over the center of the board. So once we're here and there's a little bit of tension on there, in fact, we might even fight for this position, which I'll talk about in the next video. Then the referee sees it's in the center, they say, Che! Remember that word, Che! Because that means go. And when they say go, then we can start pulling. Which brings up the next part, the hips. Before that Che command happens, you better have your hips back. The closer to the board your hips are, the worse leverage you have and the more chance you have of just flying right over that thing. In fact, we're gonna demonstrate that right now. Well, I'm gonna show you the difference between hips close to the board and hips further away from the board so you have an idea of what I'm talking about. My hips are close to the board right now. I'm starting here, watch what happens. Go for it. Whoa! Yeah, like that. Now, she's got a pretty big pull. I'm gonna have her pretty much put all that she can into this. My hips are gonna be far enough back that I can defend. So this is the difference. She still pulled pretty hard there, but she's gonna pull even harder now, and I'm gonna be able to defend. Go for it. Ready, go. She's trying. Pull, 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 and I can defend. That's the difference between your hips close and your hips far. So the constant general rule of thumb, try to keep your hips back. The closer your hips get to the board, the more in jeopardy you happen to be. And we will take advantage of it. Any good Moss wrestler will notice as soon as your hips get close to the board and they'll attack. So when you set up, you find your feet position. We're going to choose our hand position. We get it over the board. We get our hips back. And then the referee or whoever's leading this will say, Jay, and then we go. In the next video, we'll talk about what happens next.